basically.
Back in another episode. Actually, today, if this thing can load, I've actually discovered a new item that's going to be in this update, the debug stick. You don't know what that is. It can change things, and it can also glitch certain things. Should you like to use the debug stick on grass? Like turn in the snow if you jump back. It also changes direction with the terracotta blocks. It can also change the settings. Yeah, and you can also power on redstone lamps without even using redstone. And glitch doors, glitch out pistons. And if I make it, I'm not gonna have to put it over. And look at this. This is actually a glitch. If you remove that, you can actually get a shaft piston. Oh dear. There you go. You can actually regrow one. Do that. You can actually do double right click to change the setting. And you can actually make a chest invisible. Just reveal it like this, and the chest is completely hidden out of existence. Don't know where it is. It's really cool. You can actually change it so that it's waterlogged. You can change you have to make it look a bit weird. So like you can actually reverse. So like I can show you, you can really, like, you can glitch the doors like that. It's weird. Like, you can actually glitch some things with this. Basically, I think there's another one. I know it won't work for the furnace. Yes, with minecart rails. Let's take a couple. Screw you. Let's take an escalator rail. It actually is powered by a station. Let's add tracks on it. Or add a minecart on it. If you add any type of rail on it, it will update. Really cool. It's pretty controller, if you add something on it, it'll update. It'll update. Meaning that it revert back to its normal position. Sometimes that can get really annoying, but it's no big deal. I don't know about perfect. No problem. Can't do that. Anyways, it might be perfect. No property. Let's go in. And then, it's weird. But as soon as you add blocks to it, it'll update. last year. Like, you can actually glitch. And it's just really weird. It does not work for redstone torches. Don't know why. But if you have any block from certain things, the block will update itself. Meaning that the things will reset. Which gets pretty annoying, but you'll probably have a lot of fun glitching. Making glitches and glitch the Minecraft system. That's another one. No brainstorms won't work. Yeah, next time I make the check. Okay, now that didn't work. But just remember, as soon as you add any block in front of it, it'll update itself. Same thing for which can be useful for automated lighting. Like, you can have it more lit. Basically, now it's using it in real-world context.
So let's go back to this world. When I discovered that I could do this. Basically, here's one name.
So basically, there is some glazed terracotta that I wanted to manage, and we're about to get there. I'm actually going to kill Apparition. Basically, what we want to do is we want to make sure that this is right. Alright, that's right. Oh, we can actually change stair blocks too. But this doesn't look right. I'm gonna fix that. Alright, there we go, that's right. Sometimes I can correct some things without even having to take the whole thing apart. It's really nice, and it's a big save. Basically, I wanted to confirm that our pancake's good, looking good here. Basically, when you're building things, you just want to add it in a sequence. Use the debug stick. If you use the debug stick, then it will go well with it. Just place the blocks in any order. So, like, for example, I am planning on using red terracotta in this hallway. Whatever you notice, it's not in sequence. Let's use this. So let's go west. It should be south, east, and east, north. And repeat that pattern. See, that's what terracotta does. If you put it in the right sequence, use the debug stick and it can help you a lot. You also change your rotation with the slab, which is also a bit weird as well. Some of the things I happen to notice. Ooh, see the glazed terracotta, that looks cool. Because now we're actually going to make a hallway going down this way. That will be a sand glazed terracotta. Basically, just place it in any order you want, it doesn't matter. Because when we used the bug stick, those look like Reaper mascots. Anyway, watch for the lines. So basically, like that, you should see a little square in the middle that means you got it correctly. So basically, it's just like a puzzle. Make sure you put the pieces in the right spot. So basically, this is where it gets really, really cool about this. Is that you can actually use the bug stick to actually configure settings. So like, Cian is the mascot of Creepers. Basically, when you do like a more full way, you want to make sure you want to match pattern. So basically, it is much easier to attempt. So basically, this one, if you're doing under like slabs, it's going to be the hardest. It's just to remove those paintings. Which, they already did it for me. So now, if you want to do like a free watch, just make sure you follow this pattern. Just add it. Lucky. Oh yeah, I already did that. There we go. Anyway, so basically what you just saw here, I just worked hard on the Suricata. So basically this debug stick can be extra useful for when you're configuring Suricata. Not gonna lie, I'm actually change this area as well. And Glaze Terracotta, just wanted to teach you a little trick. You can actually craft those by smelting terracotta, which you can find in the Mesa Biome, which I'm actually am in with. Basically, do the same thing. This one's another easy one, because they look like lines. And it's similar to like a password puzzle. So basically, it's a really cool idea that maybe I may have just the bug stick on here by accident. Oh, and just fair warning, Glaze Terracotta is an immovable object to pistons. Just wanted to let you know that they are immovable to pistons. So don't use it in piston doors. Which is my pretty bad news, a really big disadvantage of using the terracotta, Glaze Terracotta blocks. I don't know why it's considered not movable objects, but I should figure out why that is. Like, why would they make it not an immovable object, the pistons? They should be movable. And why no one told me that, man. Wrong subject pronoun. That's, like I said, the wrong subject pronoun. I would never do that in my Let's Plays. Like, I would just say the subject pronoun wrong. Anyway, Glaze Terracotta is not good for piston doors. So here we have the brewing lab, and basically there's some glitching around here as well. You can actually change the water levels. That's sick. Basically, you can actually... And the purple glazed terracotta, I like the looks because they actually have swords on them. I like the looks. Swords. Basically, this one's yet again the easiest. That right there. display like that. When you're watching this, you're at your house. But don't do it on piston doors nor secret entrances that involve a piston, because they're not movable yet. But they should be. I would agree, they should be movable. Well, why would it not be movable? Anyway, terracotta is a really good block. Yeah, something like that. Example, don't use terracotta. This one out here, yes, I did change the appearance of the grass to make it look snowy. But I won't change it with terracotta. Ooh, whiteboard. Make us rip that Pangea ramp thing again. Which no one told us that was going to be on the midterm. So now I'm starting to worry that it's actually going to be on the finals. Hope not. Because we can almost never write the requirements in one paragraph without losing points. Anyway, as you see here, I am placing around terracotta blocks. What am I doing? Anyways. See, it's a lot useful when you're playing with terracotta blocks. It's become much easier to manage your thing like that. I'm sorry it's taking so long. I'm going to have to do a ton of editing. Oh, and some other bad news. I just got a rumor to receive intelligence. If you are a listening person, then you should say something like, I have received intelligence. In context that the ministry has received intelligence, that there may be a block schedule change at Glen High again. Like, this is the second year we were on an organized blue and white block schedule, and they're changing again. And they're going to try to have classes meet like 3 times a week. I really don't like the idea behind that. That means for certain classes, I am given less time to get my work done. Unless if those periods are a study hall, then it wouldn't. No, but it's probably going to be every class, because 8 periods, you're having students meet 3 times a week. Although it's a whole lot stressful. But anyway, my finished product for the white based terracotta looks cool. Anyways, I think it's time for me to end this episode. Anyway, thank you guys for watching. I'll see you in the next episode, everybody.